wounded knight that bore the rowing sheet. Loud and cruel were the ravens' cries that feasted on the field, saying, "Beg water cold and clear, we'll never claim your hoon. There's none but the witch of the Westmoreland can make the hailing sound. So turn, turn your stallion's head till his mane flies in the wind, and the rider of the moon goes by, and the bright star falls behind." And clear was the pale moon when his shadow passed him by. Below the hills were the brightest stars when he heard the owl cry, saying, "Why do you ride this way, and wherefore came you here? I seek the witch of the Westmoreland who dwells by the winding mere." By the eel's water and the misty brake fern way, till through the cleft of the kirkstone pass the winding water lay. He said, "Lie down, my brindled hound, and rest ye, my good grey hawk, and thee, my steed, may graze thy fill, for I must dismount and walk. But come when ye hear my horn, and answer swift the call, for I fear as the sun will rise this morn, ye will serve me best of all." And it's down to the water's brim he's borne the rowing sheet, and the golden rod he has cast in to see what the lake might yield. And wet rose she from the lake, and fast and fleet went she, one half the form of a maiden fair with a jet-black mare's body. Hep! Loud, long, and shrill he blew, till his steed was by his side. High overhead the grey hawk flew, and swiftly he did ride. "Set course well, my brindled hound, and fetch me the jet-black mare. Stoop and strike, my good grey hawk, and bring me the maiden fair." She said, "Pray sheathe thy silvery sword, lay down thy rowing sheet, for I see by the briny blood that flows you've been wounded in the field." And she stood in a gown of velvet blue, bound round with a silver chain, and she kissed his pale lips once and twice, and three times round again. And she's bound his wounds with a golden rod, full fast in her arms he lay. And he has risen hale and sound, sun high in the day. She said, "Ride with your brindled hound at ease, and your good grey hawk in hand. There's none can harm the knight who's slain with the witch of the Westmoreland."